Dear students, welcome to DICJ Home Classes, a digital initiative by Directorate of School Education, Jammu. I am Jyoti Diwan. I am going to teach you a one-act play, Box and Cox by John Madison Morton, Chapter 18th, Class 12th. Dear students, I am glad to be here with you. Before I start, I introduce you to the playwright John Madison Morton. John Madison Morton was born in 1811 in Pangbourne, a large village on the River Thames in the English country of Berkshire. He was an English playwright who specialized in one-act farces. His most famous farce was Box and Cox in 1847, which the New York Times in 1891 called the best farce of the 19th century, and after this achievement, he died in the same year. Box and Cox was widely successful, earning him about 7,000 pounds and was translated into many European languages. It was adapted as a one-act comic opera in 1866. By the dramatist F.C. Burnand. Dear students, I will make you understand what one-act play is. A one-act play is a play that has only one act, as distinct from plays that occur over several acts. One-act plays may consist of one or more scenes. The origin of the one-act play may be traced to the very beginning of drama. In ancient Greece, Cyclops, a satyr, play by Euripides, is an early example. A good one-act play focuses on one main action or problem. There is not time to get into complicated layers of plot. It's a good idea to keep your play to one set and as few scenes as possible. A one-act play is 9 to 12 pages with 4 characters or less. Dear students, before I start, I would like to share a quick story about Box and Cox. Box is a painter. He works all night. Cox is a hatter. He works all day. Box rents a room from Mrs. Bouncer, a lodging housekeeper, telling her he will only use it in the daytime. Cox visits Mrs. Bouncer and asks for a room, telling her he will only use it at night. She rents the same room to both of them, then starts a strange series of situations. Mrs. Bouncer must get Cox out of bed before Box comes home, and Box out of bed before Cox comes home. She uses all sorts of subterfuges to keep Box downstairs in the dining room, while Tilly, the housemaid, chases Cox out of the house and then straightens up the room. This works for a while, until one day Cox oversleeps and Mrs. Bouncer, thinking he has gone, allows Box to go upstairs. He tumbles into bed and is surprised to find it occupied. A fight follows and Box kicks Cox downstairs. He complains to Mrs. Bouncer and, going upstairs with Cox, confesses that she had rented the room to the both of them. Box, who up to this moment had not noticed Cox, recognizes him as an old acquaintance, and renewing all old ties, they agree to share the room together. Now, we will discuss the theme of the play, or Box and Cox as a farce. This play is based on the theme that it's possible to create fun through exaggeration and ridiculous situations. Such situations are farcical. A farce is a cheap type of comedy. It's full of fun. The characters in a farce usually get involved in ridiculous and unlikely situations. The play is a farce from beginning to the end. It's really farcical that two men should be the lodgers of the same room and they don't know about it. Cox is a funny man. He wants to take a vow that he will never have his hair cut again. He says that the barber has almost moved his head. His complaint about his pillow is also farcical. He tells Mrs. Bouncer that he needs a bigger or heavier pillow. The present pillow that he is using has a handful and a half of feathers at each end and nothing whatever in the middle. Before leaving for work, Mr. Cox puts on a hat which wobbles on his head. His complaint about the consumption of coal is also very funny. There is an increasing evaporation of his candles, wood, sugar and matches. Mrs. Bouncer expresses the hope that she is not suspected of theft of these things. Cox tells Mrs. Bouncer that he doesn't say that she is stealing those things. But he also says that it's not even the cat. This remark is very funny. Cox further complains that he frequently finds that apartment is full of tobacco smoke. Mrs. Bouncer says that the man in the attic is always smoking a pipe and he is sending his smoke down. Cox then remarks that this gentleman's smoke doesn't follow the example of all other sorts of smoke and takes a contrary direction. Mrs. Bouncer keeps the two lodgers in the same room by putting Cox's things out of Mr. Box's way. She does it in a satisfactory way until she is found out because Mr. Box remains on duty in the press at night and Mr. Cox works in a hat shop during day. She doesn't forget that the head of the bed for Mr. Cox becomes the foot of the bed for Mr. Box. The coal or breakfast is also farcical. Finally, Mrs. Bouncer apologizes for being a bit greedy and this brings the play to a close. We burst into peals of laughter at the remarks of Mr. Cox, the coal or breakfast things and other funny situations. Both claim to be the actual tenants of that room. Finally, when the secret is opened, they ask Mrs. Bouncer, "Whose room is this?" Bewildered, Mrs. Bouncer starts crying and says, "Both of them." Now we see how Mrs. Bouncer befools her tenants. Mrs. Bouncer had a lodging house. She rented the room with cupboards and beds to two tenants, Mr. Box and Mr. Cox. She did that very shrewdly, because the hours of duty of the two men were such that they could not be present in the room at the same time. Mr. Box was a printer. Cox was a hat maker. Cox was at work throughout the night. Cox was at work for the whole day. The two lodgers rarely saw each other. One day, both happened to be there. They started quarreling as to who was the tenant. Mrs. Bouncer was forced to intervene. She confessed having acted greedily. She confessed that she rented out the room to both of them for her lust for money. Dear students, now we read the character sketch of Mrs. Bouncer. Mrs. Bouncer is a female component of John Madison Martin's one-act play of Fox, Box and Cox. Though seemingly an insignificant and less important dramatic personal, yet it is she round whom the other two characters, Mr. Cox and Mr. Box, revolve. She resembles the spectacle of a puppet master who occupies position behind the curtain but whose fingers hold the threads that make puppet revolve the dance. Though not mentioned, Mrs. Bouncer seems to be a middle-aged lady full of vigor and wit. She is always found up and doing, vigilant and watchful. She is in need of money. She is by nature covetous lady, and it is this trait of personality that makes her let out a single room to two tenants, simultaneously taking undue advantage of their calling Mr. Box, a hatter requiring the room to spend nights. Mr. Cox, a printer, needing it for days only. Mrs. Bouncer is quite active and alert. It is evident by her not letting even the suspicious dawn on either of the two tenants for quite some time that they are occupying the same room. At times, she presents a miserable spectacle. She is accused of stealing by both her tenants, but she turns a deaf ear to their insulting remarks merely to ensure receiving double rent for a single room. She presents a typical example of farcical with uncivil language, abusive and deceitful dealings. As is inevitable in all such farcical plots, her treachery is finally found out and she is put to shame and disrespect quite justifiably. Dear students, now we read the character sketch of Mr. Cox. Mr. Cox is one of the two lodgers of Mrs. Bouncer. He is a hatter. He works in the daytime in a hat shop. He is very polite. The barber has given him a bad haircut. Instead of losing his temper on the barber, he decides not to have haircut again. He does not enjoy a comfortable sleep at night because he doesn't have a good pillow. He requests Mrs. Bouncer to supply him a bigger and better pillow. He never becomes rude. He makes his complaint about his room being full of smoke in a very polite way. He is a picture of politeness. He has a very good sense of humor. His talk with Mrs. Bouncer is laced with humor. His remarks about his haircut are very humorous. He thinks that he has been moved like a lawn. His remarks about his bolster having about handful and a half of feathers at each end is also humorous. He complains that his candles, wood, sugar and matches are getting consumed very fast. When Mrs. Bouncer asks him if he suspects her of having stolen them, he says that he doesn't suspect her, but he also adds that the cat could not have taken them. For his politeness and humor, he is a likable character. He seems to be the life of the play. Dear students, now we see the character sketch of Mr. Box. Mr. Box is the second male character in the play. He is a lodger of Mrs. Bouncer. He works in a newspaper press. He goes for night duty. He doesn't come back home till the morning. He rarely meets Mr. Cox. He is a bit short-tempered. He is rude. Mrs. Bouncer puts Cox's things out of Mr. Box's way. She puts the key where Cox always finds it. Mr. Box smokes very frequently when he is off duty. Mr. Cox has complained to Mrs. Bouncer that he finds his room always full of tobacco smoke. Mrs. Bouncer tells him that he should not lose his temper so soon. He tells Mrs. Bouncer to mind her own business. When Mrs. Bouncer tries to talk with him, he expresses his desire to go to bed. He wants her to leave his room. Mrs. Bouncer tells him not to smoke frequently. Box has no intention to stop smoking. He tells Mrs. Bouncer to ask Cox to find accommodation elsewhere. He is not willing to tolerate any obstacle in the way of his smoking. He warns Mrs. Bouncer, if she makes any attempt to stop him from smoking, he will leave her room and go elsewhere. It shows that he is very firm, rude and ill-tempered. He is of the view that Mrs. Bouncer steals his coals, candles and sugar. He calls with cocks who happens to return from duty on account of a sudden holiday. Now, let us have a look at some important questions. Why does Cox want Mrs. Bouncer to change his bolster? Bolster means pillow. Cox wanted Mrs. Bouncer to change his bolster because he couldn't sleep comfortably during the night. He had the habit of taking a bulging bolster. Some of its feathers had been taken out. How is Mrs. Bouncer's idea of renting out the same room to two sets of lodgers a capital idea? Renting out the same room to two sets of lodgers is a capital idea because neither of the two lodgers knows the other. She is getting double rent for her room, so it's beneficial for her. Why does Cox say, "This gentleman smoke," instead of emulating the example of all other sorts of smoke? And going up the chimney thinks proper to affect our singularity by taking the contrary direction. He implies that Mrs. Bouncer smokes secretly. She states that the gentleman in the attic is hardly ever without a pipe in his mouth. But she commits an error when she says that the gentleman sits smoking his pipe with his feet on the mantelpiece. This makes Cox say in wonder how that gentleman's smoke takes an opposite direction towards him instead of going up the chimney. As soon as Cox leaves the room, Mrs. Bouncer gets busy in the room. What does she do and why? She puts Mr. Cox's things out of Mr. Box's way. She takes the three hats, Cox's dressing gown and slippers, opens the door at left and puts them in. She then shuts the door and locks it. She removes Cox's things to ensure that Box doesn't happen to see any of them. She also makes the bed in such a way that the head of the bed for Mr. Cox becomes the foot of the bed for Mr. Box. Who does Cox suspect in using his stuff? Cox suspects that the landlady Mrs. Bouncer was using his stuff. Why did Cox come home early? What did he get for breakfast? Cox came home early because his employer didn't allow him as he was late for his work. He got a mutton chop for his breakfast when he came back home early. Though both Box and Cox start cooking breakfast, neither of them gels anything to eat. Why? They don't get anything to eat because both throw each other's piece of meat out of the window. Who is Box angry with as he enters? Why? Box is angry with the man with whom he glides on the staircase. He has come after finishing his night duty. He is exhausted and wants to sleep. He had an exchange of words with the man on the stairs. Why does Box feel agitated when he starts cooking his breakfast? Mr. Box feels agitated because he can't find his things. His matchbox is gone. His candles, coals and sugar are not at the place he left. He found his gridiron used by somebody. It smelt of red herrings. Dear students, let us have a look at vocabulary which is used in the play. Emphatic, forceful, moved, cut like grass, absurdity, foolishness, wobble, jump, evaporation, disappearance, grumble, complain without any cause. Cheroot, cigar with both ends open. Havana, a kind of cigar. Attic, a small room on the top of a building. Fender, metal frame around an open fireplace. Hob, metal shelf at the side of the fireplace. Emulate, imitate. Singularity, strangeness. Bolster, pillow. Divesting, removing. Brim means top. Nape means smooth, hairy surface. Perish means finish, bacon, meat of swine, pork, flesh of swine. Impregnated means filled with herrings of wood fish. Sneaking, entering stealthily, means चुपके से कहीं पे प्रवेश करना. Benevolence means kindness, countenance, face expression. Bewildered, surprised, curb, to check. Indignation, anger, vengeance means revenge. Here are some words with the meaning in simple English. Mental peace, it's a structure over a fireplace. Protuberant, it means sticking out, कुछ उभरी हुई चीज. Lore, it's a colloquial expression for Lord. डेली रूटीन में जो हम लॉर्ड के लिए, भगवान जी के लिए एक्सप्रेशन यूज करते हैं, लैंग्वेज यूज करते हैं. एफ्लुविया, इट मीन्स स्मेल, बैड स्मेल. परलॉइंस मीन्स टू स्टील समथिंग विदाउट परमिशन. नाउ अवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज जॉन मेडिसन मॉर्टन इज नोन फॉर. द आंसर इज फॉसिस. द प्ले बॉक्स इन कॉक्स इज अ. द आंसर इज फॉस. हास्य रसे भरपूर नाटक, अ कॉमेडी विथ चीप डायलॉग्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई टेल यू फॉर योर इन्फॉर्मेशन, बॉक्स एंड कॉक्स हैज एंटर्ड एज फ्रेज इन द इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. द ऑक्सफोर्ड इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी डिफाइन्स इट एज अप्लाइड एलूजिवली टू एन अरेंजमेंट इन विच टू पर्सन्स टेक टर्न्स इन सस्टेनिंग अ पार्ट, ऑक्युपाइंग अ पोजिशन are the like. So, I sincerely appreciate that I have had this opportunity to present to you. If anyone has any question, please feel free to ask in comment box. Thank you very much. Stay safe and healthy.